Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's look at document title bars and proxy icons. So let's run TextEdit and create a new document. Now, title bar is what you see here at the top, and it has the title of the document in it. And if you roll over it, you can see a little down reveal triangle that you can click on and access several things about this document. And here you can change the name, or in this case set the name since I haven't yet saved this document. You can add tags. You can specify where the document is to live, in a folder, on iCloud. You can use other to select any location that you can reach. And you can also lock the file. Now you notice that's grayed out. And also the icon here is missing. This is because I haven't saved the file yet. Let me do that. Let me do Command S here. Save the file to the desktop. And now you can see I have this proxy icon here and I have the locked option available to me now. So you see I can click on the title here and change the name of the document without ever having to leave the application or close the document, go to the Finder, anything. You can see it will change here on the desktop. I can also move it without having to leave the application or even look at a window in the Finder. I can move it to the Documents folder. You can see it disappears from the desktop and it will now appear in Documents. You can see there it is, my document.txt, and I can move it back if I want to. I can even move to and from iCloud using this. Now another thing you could do with the title bar is to command click on the title, and what that'll give you is a list here of the folder that the document is in and the folder that's in all the way all up to the main level of your computer. So if I select that, it will actually open a Finder window for that folder. So this kind of gives you the idea of the path of where the document is stored. Now another thing you can do up here is use this proxy icon here and drag it. You can drag it to another window or folder in the Finder. I've created this untitled folder here. And you can see by the little curved arrow with the cursor there that it will create an alias to that document. So a shortcut to it. I could also hold down the Option key and instead of creating an alias it will have that little green plus button, and that means that it's going to create a copy of that document. So I've created a copy of that document. The original is still there and I'm still working with the original here. Now that's only somewhat useful because you know creating aliases and copies are pretty easy to do in the Finder. But you can also use the proxy icon to drag and drop into another application. For instance, I have a mail window open here. I'm working on this document here and I want to put a copy of it and email it to somebody. I can drag the proxy icon to the window here that I'm composing a new message, and you can see it attaches it to the message. Now you can also drag the proxy icon to other applications to open up a copy of it. So I'm going to type something in here. So I have something in the document. I'm going to drag the proxy icon to Pages, which of course you would imagine is compatible because they both are text editors. And you can see I've got this here and it's a copy. You can see there's no proxy icon, which means I haven't saved this yet. So as soon as I want to go and save it, it will save it as a separate document. So you're not actually opening the same document in multiple windows. You're opening a copy of it. Kind of in the same way that you were putting a copy of it into an email message. And one last thing I want to show you is that when you change something in the document you'll see an edited indicator up here that tells you that the file has now been edited. And if I go and Command S, which is save, you can see the edited goes away. And then it appears again when I make another change. So you can kind of glance at your title bar and know whether or not something has changed. So keep in mind that these things work for documents but not necessarily for all application windows. For instance, when you're viewing something like say viewing a web page in Safari, you're not going to have all these options. But when you create a document in Pages, you will have these options. And also keep in mind that these are standard things for the Apple apps like Pages, Numbers, Keynote, TextEdit, etc. and a lot of other developers who follow the same design as Apple. But not all third-party apps are going to have the same functionality in the title bar and with the proxy icon.